Hey guys, good day and welcome to my YouTube channel, Just Everything in Mobile Technology. Alright, so recently a follower requested in the comments that I should make a video on how to properly set up AetherSX2 controller setting, and I thought about it and that's why I decided to make this video as per my follower request to show you how to properly set up your AetherSX2 controller setting. So I'll be doing the recording right now with my AetherSX2 application right here. Just make sure you follow every step along the way. So without taking much time, let's get straight into it. Okay, so here we are right here in the AetherSX2 application. So what you want to do right now is to head straight to that game you want to configure or set up the controller settings. So I'll be using Call of Duty 3 right now. Okay, so I'm going to wait for it to load before I hit a pause. Alright, so it has loaded. Now I pause it, then you should see this, the fourth icon in the among these five at the top left, the one that looks like PPSSPP right here. So just click that, then this large menu should appear. Now this video is only for those who are trying to set up their touchscreen controls. I'll be making a video later on for those who are trying to set up external controls like your gamepad, your DualShock, your Xbox, your PlayStation pad, stuff like that. So what we're going to do right now is to go to the touch screen for those having trouble setting the touch screen controller up. So we have you see this, all this list right here. We have touch screen controller view, then just make sure that it's on dual analog pad. Then touch screen controller ports, make sure it's on port 1. Now what you want to do is to add or remove whichever buttons you need or whichever buttons you don't need. So once we click that, you can see all these buttons, the L1, the L2, the select, the start, triangle, circle, cross, all those just like that. So right here in Call of Duty, particularly in this game, you'll be needing the R3 and the L3. So, and you can see they are not selected right here. So what I want to do right now is just to select the R3 and the L3. So I also need one thing here in this game. I'll need the fast forward, toggle fast forward button. Alright, so I have that already. So anything you also feel you need right here, you can also add it to your menu. So just press done after you've added or removed any button you want or you don't want. So right now what we want to do is that button is right now, it's not in a proper place. Now let me show you how it is. Let me close this. Now you can see the L3 and the R3, they're kind of too small right here. So what you want to do right now is trying to adjust their position, their size. So just pause that. You can see the fast forward button at this corner, it's not really staying in the right place. So just pause that, then head over to the icon right here, then touch screen. And what we want to do right now is to scroll, then move this move buttons section here. Just tap that. Now you have this menu right here. Now this menu can assist you in moving the buttons all over the screen, resizing them. So this menu can also help you to add or remove buttons. You can do it from here as well. So what you want to do right now is just to tap the edit menu, this blue stuff right here. Then you can see different options for you, right? So to even change the opacity of those buttons. So right now I want to move this fast forward button first. Now I just tap this move button, then I'm able to move this toggle fast forward button right here. I'm able to move it around, as you can see, and I'm also able to resize this if I want. I just tap the edit menu again, then tap move buttons, edit menu, then tap resize buttons, then I can resize it right now. So don't forget, if you want to move it, just tap edit menu, move buttons, you can move it all around the screen, then edit menu again, then resize button, so you can resize that as you like. So right now we can just start configuring everything, start setting everything up. So I just move this one, tap the edit menu, then move the fast forward button right here so that it fits in. I'm able to see it and tap it easily as I want. Then I can also move this analog up here so it stays there. Then I tap it again, then move the R3 and L3 a little bit up. and I can also resize them by tapping it again, then pressing resize. Gonna resize them like this. So this is how I want my controls to be. It depends on how you want yours to be. Just make sure everything is okay for your gameplay. So I can also tap this edit menu, then move to move this D-pad. This D-pad is looking kind of too above there. So everything is okay for my game right now. Just depends on you. Now we can exit editor as well. And don't forget, you can also change the opacity of those buttons by tapping the change opacity at the top right here. So right now we're going to exit the editor by using the last option, exit editor. Now it should bring you directly to your game. Now just pause it, and we also want to explore other options. Let's see what other options are available for us in this menu. So we tap that again, then this menu should appear, then touch screen. Then we can also see that we have an option to adjust the opacity from this menu. Instead of going into the edit menu, we also have the option to adjust the overlay opacity, and we also have the option to hide the buttons when not in use for specific periods. So you can also set the seconds. So for example, if you set 5 seconds, after 5 seconds and you didn't touch those buttons will automatically fade in the background. You won't see them again on the screen. So we also have vibration on press, or also we also have vibration on press. You can turn that on if you want the buttons to vibrate while you touch it. And game vibration also, you can also enable game vibration. So basically that is all you need to know under the touch screen controller settings. So those looking for external controller settings, I'll be making a video on that later on. So make sure you subscribe. If you are just new to this channel, subscribe, give this video a like, and feel free to express yourself in the comment section. If you need a help, I can assist in emulating your games, your controls further. So do have a good day and stay tuned for more content like this. Thank you.